First thing first, you gotta see what you need. You heard what I said. You gotta see what you need. So you gotta stop talking about my wife ain't doing this and my wife ain't cooking. I'm working. My wife not, you know, sexually active enough. I'm working. I'm paying bills. My wife is not there for me like she used to. First of all, listen to me. You gotta see what you need. And what you gotta learn, John F. Kennedy said it best, it is not what your country can do for you, baby. It's what you can do for your country. So you got to change your whole mindset. You got to stop looking at this thing as my wife not doing this. My wife not doing that. She should be doing more of this. She should be doing more of that. Man up. That's right. You heard what I said. Man up. It's time to change your focus. See what you need. If your wife ain't cooking for you, you cook for her. If your wife's not being sensitive, you be sensitive. If your wife is not saying, you know, all the loving things that you want to hear, then you say loving words to her. Listen to me. If your wife, is she not doing what you think she should be doing, see what you need. All right. I need you to set a fix. Now, if you ever been in the Navy, baby, you've ever sailed on a ship before, you know what I'm talking about. When I say set a fix, what I'm talking about is you set your mind on a certain thing, and I promise you, when you set it on that certain thing, what you're saying is, come hell or high water, I'm fixed on that, and we're gonna get to that destination. And what I need you to do is set a fix on the fact that your marriage is gonna be better than it's ever been before, that this is gonna be the best year that your wife has ever had, that your son has ever had, that your daughter has ever had. You're gonna set a fix, and even though the currents may come and the winds may blow, it's not gonna bother you because you've set a fix and you made up in your mind you are going to get to that mark. So number one, baby, see what you need. If you want your wife to be a better person, you need to be the person you want your wife to be. Now, I got a funny story. Catch this, right? So my wife and I, we young, we probably been married for about 3 or 4 years, right? So my wife is saying that she don't wash clothes because we got to go to the laundromat. And you know what I'm saying? She don't really have time as a student at that time. She didn't have time to go to the laundromat. So your boy E.T., I don't know no better, right? So I buy an apartment. We get a nice apartment, a new apartment, and it's furnished with a washer and dryer. And so we move into this place, bruh, and the clothes are piling up. And I'm like, yo, sweetheart, come here for a minute. Let me holler at you. Right, so I throw the washer and dryer. I'm like, boo, you remember you told me that you weren't washing clothes because we weren't, you remember that? You said you weren't washing clothes because of the laundromat. Well, now we got a washer and dryer, and you didn't. And you know, brothers, I'm married. For those of you who don't know, you didn't see the profile picture. I'm married to a sister, right? And sister girl was like, if you want your clothes washed, you wash them yourself. Now watch this. I started to get an attitude about it, but from that day forward, my marriage went to a place that has never gone to before. Listen to me. We've been married over 20 years. That's right. Your boy E.T. been married over 20 years, and my wife said 18 out of the 20 have been great. So I think, you know, in terms of percentages, that's real good. But you know what I did that day? I started to see what I needed. That's right. From that day forward, I started washing clothes. I started drying clothes. I started separating clothes. I started folding clothes. I started putting clothes up. I started cooking for my wife. I started sending my wife flowers to her job. I started washing her car. I started putting gas in her car. And let me tell you something. When I started seeing it, when I started taking care of her, when I started doing for her, I don't know if by beholding you become changed or she was just shamed. But all of a sudden, I saw my wife start to change. That's right. I didn't have to cuss at her. I didn't have to be manipulative. I didn't have to lay hands on her. I served her. That's right. I served her. It's not what they can do for you. It's what you can do for them. And so what our wives need, they need us to man up. What our children need is they need us to man up. They need men. They need people who, this is what Paul said. When I was a child, I spake as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. But when I became a man, that means it was a transformation, that it was a shift, that something happened, that he went from boy to man, meaning that it wasn't about him no more. It wasn't about self. It wasn't about, baby, you ain't giving me enough sex. Baby, you ain't giving me enough attention. Baby, you ain't giving me enough time. It was a shift, and it was no longer what can you do to make me happy, but what can I do to make you happy? So I'm telling all my brothers out there, I'm not minimizing. Does your wife need to take care of you? Yes. But I'm saying you do it first if she's not doing it. You lead by example. Are you hearing what I'm saying? I can't guarantee you in 30 days. I can't guarantee it in 60 days. I can't guarantee it in 90 days. But what I can tell you is that if you alter something, if you change, if you grow up and you start looking, let me tell you something. My wife couldn't leave me if she wanted to, right? She couldn't leave me if she wanted to. Why? Because you ain't going to find another man who's going to iron your clothes every day. You're not going to find another man when it's 6 degrees, wash your car, take your car to the gas station, fill your gas up. And if you do, it don't make sense to get the same model that you already got, baby. Are you hearing what I'm saying? It's a mentality. So I'm not going to lose my marriage. Why? Because I set a fix and I'm determined to win. Every single day when I wake up, I'm going to make sure that the marriage today is sweeter than it was yesterday. That the romance is better today than it was 20 years ago when we first hooked up. So I got to get you this. This thing is deep right here. I said it. If she not cooking, if she not cleaning, you do it. Listen to me. You said, E.T., come on. No. How bad do you want it? This is an investment. I don't care nothing about the fact that you making money. I don't care about the fact you driving a fresh ride. I don't care about the fact that you got a big house. Listen to me. Here's the goal. The goal is to be the best priest you could be. The goal is to be the best protector you could be. The goal is to be the best provider you could be. The goal is to keep your family together. Any brother can romance a woman for 90 days. Any brother can romance a sister for a year and go to another and romance her for a year. But can you keep the fire going after 5? Can you keep it going after 10? Can you get her to still love you after 15? Can you get her to still want to come home immediately after work after 20? Can you get her to still want to call you when she on lunch break after work, her 15-minute break? Do you have what it takes? Anybody can start it, but do you have what it takes to maintain it? Listen to me. For those of you out there, you saying, E.T., but she don't do this and she don't do that, and I'm ready to bounce. E, she ain't. Stop being a baby. Grow up. Stop being a child and grow up. Be a man. E, she ain't doing this and she used to do that and life used to be this. Listen to me. Stop talking about what used to be and get it back. So I need you to do me a favor, man. I'm going to keep it real, man. Sometimes when my wife get on my nerves. That's right. You heard what I said. Sometimes when my wife get on my nerve, man, you know what I got to do, man? I got to go back and I need you to go back. I need you to remember that woman that marched down the aisle. You remember that? That woman that marched down the aisle that had on that beautiful gown, who you looked at and you said, in sickness and in health, for better or for worse. Well, guess what? This is what worse looks like. When you said for better or for worse, yep, this is worse, right? That's right. And listen to me. They didn't force you to say that. You could have said when the pastor said for better or for worse, you could have been like, hey, pastor, I'm going to go with the for better thing, but I ain't really feeling it for worse. In sickness, I ain't feeling the sickness. In health, yeah, as long as she healthy. No, you didn't say that. So I want you to go back to what you said, and I want you to remember the romance. I want you to remember the time before you got married. Listen to me. Sometimes when I get mad at my wife, I got to remember, E.T., you better slow your roll. This is the same woman when you were homeless, when you didn't have a place to stay. This is the same woman who made sure she gave you her allowance. The same woman that snuck you into her mama's home to make sure you weren't out in the cold during the dead of the winter. This is the same woman when nobody else believed you were going to be a motivational speaker, told you, baby, I'll go to work every day and I help support you in your motivational career. This is the same woman. Boy, you better not forget where you come from. You better not act brand new. This is the same woman that was robbed or die. And I need you to do me a favor. Yep, I know you're going through it right now, but this storm shall pass. Like every storm that has come before, this too shall pass. But you got to do me a favor. It's got to start somewhere. It's got to start with you. So listen to me. I'm talking to my men right now, and every man that's watching this right now, every woman that's watching this right now, if you know somebody going through it in their marriage, you send this to the husband and you tell him, E.T. said, listen to me, man up. Man up, because I just believe when the man is in his rightful place and he's doing and he's being and he's acting the way he was born to act, created to act, I just believe that the God of the universe will step in and assist him. You heard what I said. I just believe that if the man is where he's supposed to be, doing what he's supposed to be, being who he's supposed to be, there ain't no force that could come up against his family. There is nothing that could come up against a man's home when the man is where he's supposed to be. Most of the problems we have today is because men are not in their rightful place. So I dare you, I challenge you, I double dare you, I triple dare you to cook, I triple dare you to clean, I triple dare you to serve, I triple dare you to seed into your wife what you need. All right, it's your boy E.T. I'm gonna throw in a bonus for you. All right, and I want you to make sure you do me a favor, man. Check out, I put it up at the end of this video. I want you to go to the Facebook page. We got a new Facebook page that's talking about the fact that, hey, that love is worth it, baby. That's right. Love is worth all the sacrifices. It's worth all the pain. So I'm going to put some tips up there for you on some things you can do to romance your wife. But the first thing I need you to do for me, and I said it, I want you to hear it, is I want you to do something for me. I want you to just get a big sheet of paper, all right? Big piece of cardboard. And I want you to take pictures of your wife, all right? Or pictures that you already have of your wife, right? right? And I want you to take these pictures that you have, right? And I just want you to fall in love with her all over again, all right? And I want you to take pictures when y'all was dating. I want you to take pictures of y'all honeymoon. I want you to take pictures of your wedding, right? And I want you to erase those negative images you have of your wife right now and of your relationship right now. And I want you to recreate the good ones. You heard what I said. I want you to recreate them. So I want you to put pictures up there, and I just want you to write down the good memories. Then I want you to get back to doing what you ought to do for those good memories, because you talk about it. My wife ain't what she used to be. Perhaps you have not created the environment you used to create. Perhaps you're working so much now. Yeah, you making money, you riding big, you doing great, you bought her a big house, but she ain't got you. Yeah, you're right, but I want you to take some responsibility. Yep, my wife may not be the woman she used to be, but be brave enough to ask yourself this question. Am I not the man I used to be? Am I not doing the things that I used to do? And if you're courageous enough to answer those questions, and if you see there's some cracks in your armor, I just want you to fix them. Now listen to me as I get out of here. This is serious to me, because a lot of the pain and a lot of the hurt that I went through in my life was because my home life wasn't right. You understand what I'm saying? That's where it started. That's why it took your boy E.T. so long to do so many things, because I didn't get the right start, the right foundation. And one of the things that I do for my babies is every day when they get home, if I don't pick them up from school, I'm at home when they get home, because I believe family is so important. So spoil your wife. Spoil your wife. I guarantee you, if you spoil her, she gonna come around. Spoil your wife. Text your wife. You texting all these other folks, text your wife. You taking all these other folks out to eat, take your wife out to eat. I guarantee if you romance her, she not gonna say no. And so get collage, get me some pictures, write down the good memories, and get in position, because God's about to show up and show out. Get in position. Once again, it's your boy E.T. Big Mike. I love you. Thanks, man, for letting me use your story. Hey, and make sure you pay attention, man. Tune in at least once a month. Your boy E.T. I'm dropping something hot and fresh out the kitchen, man. I love you. Hey, and I wish you marriage the best, baby.
Can't replace it.